Hello, this is Fo, and in this video I'm going to show how to set up basic internet connectivity using the HWIC-3G-GSM card. Now I've got a completely blank config on this router. I'll just drop into the CLI and show you the interface structure. So, brief. So you can see on here we've got some normal fast Ethernets. This is a 2800 router. And we've also got this cellular 000 interface, which is our radio interface for the 3G. So the first job that we need to do for any 3G or 4G connectivity is to set up the APN. Now, with this particular card, we do that using the cell 000 GSM profile command. Now we want to create a profile. And there's a number of slots in the card, 16, so we want to create just profile number 1. And the next thing that we need to type in here is the access point name, or APN. So in my case, 3.co.uk. Now at this point, a lot of APNs require you to authenticate. You do have options for PAP, CHAP. You can fill those out. The 3 are quite trusting. They don't make you authenticate, so we'll just hit return there. Say okay to confirm that. So the rest of the config now goes in normal config T mode. So we'll jump into the radio interface, cell 000. Now we'll set up the IP address to negotiate, because the carrier will give that to us. And we'll set our encapsulation to PPP. So it's always PPP using this card. Next step then, we set the dialer to inband. We have to use the inband method to pass the dialer string to the modem. The dialer string is a little bit quirky. Do a star, 98 star, and then you put in the number of the profile that you just configured. So we just configured up profile 1, so I put a 1 there, then you pop a hash on the end, or a pound if you call it that. So next job then is to define which dialer list we're going to use. Now the dialer list basically decides what is considered interesting traffic, so traffic that would bring up the interface, traffic that would stop the interface from timing out and shutting itself back down. So we do that using the dialer group command, and we'll use list 1, why not? Okay, so one other thing to set up on this, again, no authentication with 3, so we say PPP chat refuse. Now you can go in and set the authentication of the chat call in. You can set up your PPP chat host name, your PPP chat password. Certainly with my carrier, it makes no difference what you set those to, so you may as well just refuse them. Okay, so since this is going to be used for providing internet to my LAN, I'm going to set this up with NAT. So I'll say IP NAT outside. My favourite command of all time when you're trying to record a video, because it takes absolutely ages. Might as well go and boil an egg or something while it's doing this. There we go, it's back. And quickly say no shut on that interface. And we're finished setting that interface up. So a couple of other little things that we need to do. The dialer group that I referred to there, we need to create the dialer list for that. So we'll say dialer list 1. And we just like anything to bring this up. So protocol IP permit. So any IP traffic is going to be interesting. It'll bring that interface up and it'll keep it up. So the only other thing we need to do then is to make sure the traffic gets the interface in the first place to hit that dialer. So we set IP route 0000, so a default route here, and you can point it straight to the cellular interface. Don't need an XHOP on that, just point it straight to the interface and it'll figure it out itself. So that's the outside half of things done. were quickly set at the inside. Pretty generic, nothing special about this. So we'll go to interface first, Ethernet 00. And we'll put an IP address of 10.10.10.1. And we'll say IP NAT inside for that one. Okay. All we have left to do then is to set up our NAT. So if I create an access list, we'll just call it NAT. This just decides what gets NATed. So we'll say commit 10.10.10.0. We'll put a wildcard mask that says any last octet, so anything in the 10.10.10 range will NAT. Come over that, and then we'll say IP NAT inside source list NAT. So NAT anything that's in that access list we just created, and we'll NAT it to the interface address of the cell 000 interface when we get one. And we'll say overload so that multiple devices on the inside can use that. Okay, and that should be the entire config done. So if I pop onto my host on the LAN, and I can check, I can ping the router itself. Yep, okay, so that's working fine. So next job, let's ping 8.8.8.8 out on the internet and see if it brings that up. Okay, there we go. So you can see really high latency responses on that. That's the 3G. It's good for throughput. Well, sort of good for throughput, but really not very good for latency. And if I pop back on there, you can see the cellular 000 interface came up. There we go, lovely jibbly. So video wouldn't be complete unless I showed a couple of show commands. So here we go. The main ones to look at are show cell 000. You can see there's a bunch of different things in there, but really the interesting ones are network, to check that you're actually associated with the network. So you can see here, HSDPA attached, I'm online, and there's my carrier, 3UK. The other useful one is show cell 000 radio. So this will give you an idea of what band you're on and your signal strength. So if you're having dropouts, you can keep an eye on whether that's going up and down or yeah, whatever. Okay, there are debugs for this, the usual debug dialer. You've also got debug chat, so that lets you see what's going on between your dialer and the modem, see whether it's saying it's connecting or not. You can also do debug PVP negotiation, which is fairly verbose. So if I blow away the dialer now, dragged it down mostly. We just need to give it a second until it says the interface is ready to dial again. Right, okay, so the re-enable timeout is basically saying, right, I've pulled this interface down, I'm going to keep it down until that timeout expires. So now as soon as I do my ping again, I should pull this interface straight up. I can see it's generally loads and loads and loads of debug. This is the PVP negotiation debug. It's very verbose. I won't go into it in great detail, but basically you're looking for it to come to an agreement. If it doesn't, have a look at the confrex, the confax, confnax, confreg. That should more or less tell you which parameters it's agreeing or disagreeing on. You can usually figure it out from there. Hope that video has been useful for you. If you like that kind of thing, please pop in and have a look at my blog at networkingbodges.blogspot.com.